r/AskReddit. What game is a perfect 10 out of 10 in your book? Portal 2. Co-op is a lot of fun also. My only complaint is that there isn't enough. Good thing there's the workshop. GTA SAR. I can turn off the minimap and still make it to the end of the game. That's how many time I've played this game. Morrowind. Dated now, but first time I played it, it was mind-blowing. LOL. I'll never forget completing a long 3-part quest to get my hands on the boots of blinding speed. Once I got them, I couldn't have been more excited to put them on. They made you run much faster. A very useful and cool thing that made the rest of the game much easier. Except the boots also made you blind. Boots of blinding speed. It was right there in the name. Someone on the dev team is a DM who you should never try to use Wish anywhere near. It's easy to get around the blinding issue. Just create a spell that resists magicka 100% for 1 or 2 seconds. Cast the spell until it succeeds. Then quickly put on the boots. Voila! Blinding speed without a literal blinding. Warcraft 3. Solid campaign. Awesome multiplayer. Still being played all these years later. But most importantly, had a map editor that allowed modders to create games that would result in Dota 2. League of Legends, auto butlers, tower defenses, plants vs zombies and so much more. No other game in history has had such a long-lasting impact on online multiplayer. Battle.net on Warcraft 3 back in the day was the shit. The variety of the maps available was insane. My favorites were Footman Wars and Siege of Helm's Deep. Bioshock. I still cry when I hear "Will the Circle Be Unbroken?" The first Bioshock sent shivers down my spine for most of the game. I never knew what was going to happen or how I was going to be attacked. It was amazingly done. Super Mario Galaxy 1 and 2 are definitely among the most beautiful games ever. Mario games have always had great music. But man, did they go all out in Galaxy 1. Minecraft. Been playing for 7 years and it is limitless. And some of the mods are insane. I played with a mod in which you can literally make a spaceship out of blocks like thrusters, fuel tanks, metal etc., and launch it into space. You can go to the moon or other planets, and you also had to take care of oxygen levels. Metal Gear Solid 3, Snake Eater. It's really astoundingly beautiful. Definitely what 5 was missing. Phantom Pain had the best gameplay in my opinion, but it was just missing the poetry. Also missing a group of bosses that made Metal Gear awesome. KOTOR must be on this list. KOTOR 1 and 2 were the first RPGs I played as a kid, and they will remain some of my faves forever. The combat WAA great. The stories were great. The characters were great. And I'm glad fans managed to patch things back into the sequel to help make it even better. A crying shame we'll never get a third one. LEGO Star Wars The Complete Saga. I played LSW 1 and 2 originally on PC, then on PlayStation, and rebought it as The Complete Saga. I loved that when making The Complete Saga Edition. The folks at Traveler's Tales recognized the areas of the original versions that were just a complete pitter, mainly the podrace and some of the space levels, and reworked them. Even aside from that, the extra content they added justified the repurchase. I do miss Dex Diner as a hub, though. The Last of Us. It's like a playable novel that you just keep turning the pages and can't put down until the end. I got hooked on this game after the super intense opening sequence. I'm super excited for the second one. StarCraft. Must have spent well over 1000 hours on that game. You must construct additional pylons. Stardew Valley. I picked it up to see what all my friends were talking about. Started playing. Apparently blacked out, and woke up with 80 hours logged. Incredible. I loved it. It got me going outside to water my plants every day IRL, and I'd get mildly distressed if I didn't have enough time. They won't grow if I don't water them every day. I still think Terraria is a masterpiece. I have 500 hours unmodded. I am still not bored with it. Mass Effect 2. There probably are faults, but I can't think of any. Thank you for all the silver and stuff. RimWorld, you can harvest organs. My favorite memory of that game is when after a fight I noticed one of my guys was bleeding. They had been shot in the leg and it needed to be amputated. So I put them under anesthesia, amputated and gave them a wooden leg. A couple days later I noticed they were bleeding again. Did something happen in the meantime that I didn't see? Like a rabid animal attack? No. I amputated the wrong leg. You can create a drug empire and use the profits to make a cyborg warrior in plasteel plate mail just to kill elephant giraffe mutant. Harvest its tusk thing. Then wield the horn to murder the creature's children. You can breed exploding possum monsters and force them to clog up the kill zones so when invaders come you can set off a chain of exploding vermin. You can take the crippled survivors and stitch their fallen comrades' eyes and limbs onto them. Nurse them back to health. Then release them and their people will thank you. Zelda, Breath of the Wild. Actually fell in love with it. I bought the game along with my Switch, but didn't play until a month ago. Still playing as of today, and don't see myself stopping for another month. 11 out of 10. Super Metroid. The last Metroid is in captivity. The galaxy is at peace. Pokemon Heart Gold Soul Silver. Witcher 3. You mean that side game that comes with Gwent? Witcher 3 is the story of a grizzled warrior mage who spends all his time playing cards, and in his spare moments attempts to rid the world of question marks and occasionally big monsters. Dungeons and Dragons. Deus Ex. It is the one game which I religiously do a full story run of every other year. It's a masterpiece of design. I'll never forget my first stealth takedown with the Jepton. Donkey Kong Country, and Donkey Kong Country 2. Diddy Kong's Quest. It's actually Diddy's Kong Quest, and I only say this because it took me years to realize and understand the pun. Dark Souls. Freaking loved it. First one specifically or the series? Dark Souls 1 level design is still awe-inspiring. Divinity. Original Sin 2E is the closest to a 10 I've ever played. Some minor flaws in inventory management make it a near miss, but damn I love that game. Dragon Age. Origins. The perfect fantasy game with amazing world building and great companions. Persona 5 and Nier Automata for sure. Finally found another P5 fan here. Pokemon Mystery Dungeon Explorers of Sky. San Andreas. The Witcher 3. Old School RuneScape. Borderlands 2. Team Fortress 2. Such a shame that Valve has basically given up on updating it. Zero Escape. 999. 9 hours. 9 persons. 9 doors. Whoa, you made it to the end? You're a ducking beast. I'll cut you a deal. Smash like and subscribe for more curated content, bruh. It's free and that's a great price.